Now, in addition to adding a second sprite, you can also do something really interesting, which relates to switching a sprite's costume. When you think of a costume, you might think of an actor or an actress on stage changing clothes. But in this case, it's a little bit different. So let me show you what I'm talking about. Every sprite you click on looks like in the library it has one appearance. But the truth of the matter is that some sprites actually come with multiple versions of themselves, otherwise known as costumes. Maybe in one pose they have their hand up, and in another pose they have their hand down. Because there are two different pictures of what that sprite looks like, we refer to those as different costumes. If we go over here to the sprite icon for a new sprite, and you click on it, you'll notice, of course, that it takes us back to the library, which by now you should be pretty familiar with. Let's go ahead and click on Bat1. Now you'll notice listed below him that it says Costumes 2. What this means is that Bat number 1 has two options for how the sprite can actually look. Maybe one has his wings up and the other has his wings down. But you can choose which one you'd like for your sprite to look like. Now, some don't have any costumes, except for the one appearance they come in. You'll notice for this beetle, there's nothing below it. But now let's move on over to Dinosaur 1. Some of you might have caught this. I actually have this dinosaur as a sprite right now, and there's a very specific reason for it. This dinosaur has a 7 costume option, which means there are a whole bunch of things that I can choose from for how I want my sprite to look. So it's really up to you what you want from your sprite, because some sprites have 0 costumes, some have 2, and some, like the dinosaur here, have 7. Now I'm the type of person that likes switching things up. So let's go ahead and look more distinctly at the dinosaur. I don't really like how he's positioned right now, so I'm going to go ahead and change his costume, which is again kind of just a fancy term for his appearance or position. Scrolling up here, you'll notice that it says Costumes. If we click on this, you can see that there are all these different types of stances that are available for this one particular dinosaur. Maybe you want him roaring. Maybe you want him dancing. Maybe you want to go ahead and select a version of him looking a little bit awkward. But it's up to you, because whatever you choose is going to be reflected over here in his current state. Now, you can actually do more than just change his particular appearance. You can actually add to it yourself in a version of Paint. So right now, you'll notice that I have a couple of commands over here. You can actually go ahead and change things up using some of the options that you have. For example, this paint bucket here, if we were to go ahead and select that, and I go ahead and click the color blue on my color palette and drag it over here, you'll notice that I can actually go ahead and fill up that entire portion of his shape with blue. Let's do it for the other parts of him that are green as well. Perfect. So now I have an entirely blue dinosaur, which again is totally up to you. For the sake of my project, I'd like him to be blue. Now, one last thing. You'll notice down here that it says Vector Mode and Convert to Bitmap. Right here, our sprite right now is in vector mode, meaning that the shape is made up of lines and solid shapes. But you know what? I think that I'm going to go ahead and convert it to bitmap. You'll notice that our dinosaur changed a little bit. It looks like he became a little bit more pixelated. So if you want to go ahead and have him look more pixelated, you can definitely have him in bitmap mode. But it kind of depends on what you're looking for. This is more pixels, and this is going to be a little bit more of solid shapes. It's kind of up to you. When you finish deciding what you want your actual sprite to look like, all you do is go back up to the Scripts tab, and that'll take you back to your Scripts area, where now you can go ahead and start creating functions for what you want your sprite to do. At this point, you can always go back and change the costumes, but it's totally up to your discretion, and I encourage you to tinker around with this as much as you possibly can. Now that you've learned a little bit more about how to change a sprite's costume, what you can now do is you can learn how to actually change that costume while a program is running. And under Looks are a couple of main blocks that you're going to want to look for: Switching Costume and Next Costume. These two blocks specifically refer to particular sprites that have more than one costume to choose from. And so while a project is running, you can actually go ahead and use these blocks to, well,
have the sprite change in the middle of the actual program. So let me go ahead and show you a good example that you could use for yourself. If we just start off with the basic when green flag clicked block under the events, let's think about what we could actually do with this. Now, this particular dinosaur, as we saw before, has a number of different costumes. So one of the things that we could do is sort of make him look like he's walking by mixing motion blocks with switching costume blocks. So let me show you what I mean. Let's go back up to scripts, and we're going to have him gradually change his motion interchangeably with switching up his costume. So let's say that he goes ahead and moves 10 steps. And after that, he switches from dinosaur 1G to dinosaur 1B, which if we look back here, was this one that looks like he's actually, well, roaring. Now we'll go ahead and we'll do another motion, move an additional 10 steps, and we'll switch him to another costume. Let's do 1D, which is something that's a little bit not what I'm looking for because he sort of looks like he's dancing. So let's do something that makes him look like he's moving. We'll do 1C. How do you get rid of this block again? That's right, you can drag it back here, or you can use the scissors up here and just cut it out. So we'll switch the costume to dinosaur 1C. Okay, and then one more time, we'll do an additional move 10 steps. And let's say that he finishes at this one again, dinosaur 1A. So one more time, switch costume. Select dinosaur 1A, and boom. Okay, now let's see how he does with this. Now, if he goes too fast, we might have to make it so that we can actually go ahead and have him pause so we can see it. But let's go ahead and check it out now. Okay, so he went so fast, we actually didn't see anything. So this is what we're going to do. In between each of these, we're going to go ahead and place a wait block, which will allow for him to wait 1 second before he does the next action. Then we'll put another one right here. Okay. And now, theoretically, when we go ahead and run the program, there will be a big enough pause so that you can actually see him switching costume after costume after costume. Here we go. Perfect. Excellent. He switched each of the costumes as he was walking along. Now, the one critique I have, though, is that I don't think he was walking far enough, so I'm going to go ahead and put in 30 for each of these, and then we'll run it one more time and see if we are absolutely satisfied with our project. Here we go. A little bit better. Bigger steps, and you could see him switching costume throughout the entire thing. Excellent. Now, the other block that I showed you right here was next costume. You'll notice over here that there was an order to which these costumes come in. A, B, C, D, and E. So let's say that we just wanted him to keep changing costume in the order that we're having on our costume list. Instead of having to actually say each particular costume, we could just say next costume, next costume, next costume. So let's go ahead and do that. We'll take each of these out. And we'll just throw in a couple of next costume blocks. Great. Okay, now let's run this. And theoretically, you should see him change from one to another, and finally to another. And they should be in the order that they come. So we should start out with A, go to B, go to C, and then finally land on this funny little position here, D. Okay, so let's go ahead and see what happens. Try to think and actually recall what were the costumes that I just showed you, and remember if that is going in the order that we've dictated by using next costume. Here we go. There you go. Exactly like we said, it went in the order that the costumes are listed in, and as a result, it got us to this funny pose right here, where the dinosaur is staring at us and clearly looks very excited and very proud that we have created a good Scratch program. It's fun to play around with different types of costumes, and you can use it to vary up how your sprite is actually looking throughout the entirety of your program while it's running. This is also good to note for using multiple sprites. If you have multiple of the same sprite, switch it up so that the viewer always knows that you have more than one sprite. And even though they might look alike, in actuality, they're each their own individual character.